soul so weary. When troubles come and my heart burdened be, then I am still and wait here in the silence until you come and sit a while with me. You raise me up so I can stand on mountains. You raise me up to walk on stormy seas.
But to those who are called, well of righteousness, sanctification, and redemption. So that, as it is written, whoever boasts should boast in him.
Together with Bishop Nicholas and the priests and deacons of our diocese, I offer to you heartfelt prayer to the old siblings, to Eileen, Jean, George, to Larry and Mary, David, Lynn, Carol, and Randy, to Dale's nieces and nephews, former parishioners and friends. We priests will remember Dale and you. Singing the office of the dead, chanting the Salve Regina, Father, that I respect you as I speak to you today. We have been blessed to have a priest in your family. His life, which is no better than any of us, his life is the best of all. His prayer with you and for you, his participation in your family, is the best word for you to remember and hold on to. Jesus raised his eyes to heaven and said, Father, my disciples are your gift to me. I wish that where I am, they also may be with me. What an awesome promise. What a great consolation for us. Nailed as one of Christ's disciples. He chose to be with Christ every day, praying, offering mass, ministering to Christ's people. His life was one of God's gifts to Christ. His life was a gift to Christ. Praying to his Father at the Last Supper, Christ had no illusions about his disciples. He recognized that they were weak, they were afraid, they were abandoned. But Christ also knew how his disciples had walked with them, supported them, and been companions to him. He knew that once they witnessed his resurrection and were filled with his Spirit, that they would continue his work. Love his people. Lay down their lives for Christ. When they are retired in 2012, we moved into the Holy Family Rectory of Litterdale for the next 3 years. Almost every Saturday evening after the vigil mass, I would stop by and visit with him. Dale, of course, had his issues. He had his addiction to smoking. He had heart disease. He had throat cancer. Yet, in spite of these things, he maintained a positive attitude, a grateful attitude about each day. I experienced Dale to be a devout and prayerful man. He recognized the source of whatever strength and resolve he had. That source was Christ. And Dale was committed to staying attached and plugged into that source. We heard in the first meeting how wisdom is the revelation and the mirror of the power of God. We heard how wisdom renews everything and produces friends of God and prophets for God. The wisdom that Dale sought was Christ, and Christ produced in Dale a friend of God. I found Dale to be a humble man who aspired to serve God in his priesthood. Wherever he was assigned, he gave himself to folks. He was generous. He was kind. He was responsive to the needs of others. Unlike some of us priests, Dale was not filled with a lot of ambition to rise to a higher place. He found contentment, satisfaction wherever it was. Do not handle for larger parishes with more responsibility or prestige. No matter where he was assigned, he knew Christ was there. And Christ would sustain him. And the Holy Spirit's fire and prophetic voice were as needed there as they were in any parish. I think Dale would have meant to be a friend of God. He might argue with me that he has a prophetic voice. But we see in the gospel how God chooses the unexpected, the least likely folks to be his companions, his co-workers. The consumer society in which we live tempts us to wealth and acquisition, tempts us to recognition and applause, tempts us to comfort and constant entertainment. But the message of the cross is to love, to serve, to sacrifice for others, to share what we have, to show mercy, to be grateful. This foolishness of the cross, this foolishness of God, to which Christ calls us, St. Paul teaches, is wiser than human wisdom and stronger than human strength. Years ago, the all set his sights on serving God, sacrificing his own comfort in order to serve God's people. He delivered in that a rather simple life, avoided seeking luxury, he drove in expensive cars, he gave away a lot of his money. He and his vocation thrived in the simplicity and satisfaction of everyday prayer and routines, in enjoying conversations and noticing the humorous and ironic twists of life, which he loved to point out with a wry smile. He was grateful to receive so much from God, his faith, his childhood, his family, his vocation, his life of ministry, his brother priest, grateful for all. And in imitation of the Lord, of his Lord and Savior, he was always ready to share, to give to others without counting the cost. Our Lord has been well served. We have been much blessed. Eternal rest bring to him, O Lord, and let perpetual life shine upon him. May he rest in peace.
Banquet
of
heaven.
We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer. they may be strong in our hope for reasons of resurrection and readiness to serve others. We pray.
Death, allow any of that to suggest to the Lord to serve here in the diocese.
humbly implored by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and the blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took the bread, giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, gave it to his disciples. Take this, all of you, and eat of it, which is my body, which will be given up. In some way, in supper was entered, he took the chalice. Take this all of you and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of you. Through him and with him and in him, O God,
Thank you.
The second thing that I noticed is that he loved Carol Kelly, and he served in so many of the parishes and communities around us. Never wanted to leave him. So as I think about it, I think of renew